So in my previous video I showed you how to get the pop-up menus in Numbers to actually work with the list in another table. And it takes some work. Every time you update you have to kind of redo the pop-up menus. So is there a way to do it truly dynamically where it's going to pull from this list no matter what's in it? And the answer is yes, there is a way to do it. It requires using Automator and AppleScript and it's kind of buggy and it kind of works. I'm going to show you how, and maybe it's something you can build off of, especially if you're good with AppleScript. So I have my table 2 here. It's got these items in it. I've got table 1. This is where I want to put stuff. And here's what I've done in AppleScript. I've actually started a new Automator task. I've created a new workflow and I set it as a service. And the service receives no input and it's used in Numbers only. And then I added one thing to it, run AppleScript. So I'm basically using Automator as a way to compose AppleScript and set this up as a service. So what's going to happen? Well, so the real AppleScript is right in here. The on run, that's kind of added in there by Automator. It's going to tell the application Numbers and tell table 2 of sheet 1 of document 1. What is that? Well, that is this table 2 here. So the items that I want to get and put in this list. Very clunky to have it always look at table 2 of sheet 1 of document 1. You might need to adjust that and you could probably do some more clever AppleScript to maybe get the table by name or some other way. Then it's going to create an options list. It's going to start counting at number 2. Why? Because the first item here is just called item so I want it to start in row 2. And it's going to repeat while n is less than the number of cells in that column. So in other words, repeat from 2 all the way to 12. It's going to grab the value of that cell, store it in something called option. Then it's going to add that to the options list. So options to options and option. In other words, the current list plus the new item. And it's going to increase n by 1. It's going to repeat here until it gets all of them. And then it's done with that part. So it's populated this options variable with a list of items. Now it's going to tell the front document's active sheet to get the first table whose selection range class is range. That's a really weird way in AppleScript of figuring out what cell is currently selected. Basically saying what table has a range in it, a range of cells. And the only one that's going to have one is the one where you've selected a cell. Then tell that selection range to set the variable C to that first cell. So that first cell is going to be C. And set a variable called myChoice to choose from list options with prompt please choose default items none. So it's going to pop up a little list of all the stuff we collected here. Then it's going to set the value of that cell to that. And that's what it does. So I save that. And since I saved it as a service that works in Numbers, it should appear in Numbers Services. And we should see it here, choose from list. There it is. So I'm going to select a cell here. And I'm going to say Numbers Services, choose from list. Now notice that I can set a keyboard shortcut for that. So you do that in System Preferences, on Keyboard, Shortcuts, and then in Services, I can set a keyboard shortcut so I don't have to go through this whole thing of Numbers, Services, choose from list. And it's going to pop up a list. There it is. Please choose. And notice it has all the items that are here. I'll choose one, hit OK, and it populates that. Is it dynamic? Yes. So I'll add something else here. Let's just add other to the list. Now I'll go here. I'll say choose from list. And notice other now is at the bottom of the list. So it will add items. It will update as you change the items here. And a keyboard shortcut would make this really easy to just keep hit the keyboard shortcut, click on an item. You can even, I think, use the keyboard here. So, yep, I can use the keyboard down arrow. Okay. So with the keyboard shortcut, it makes it real easy to enter items and do that all using AppleScript. I'll include the script that you can copy and paste into Automator in the description for this video at the MacMost site.